Hi kids, how are you all? I hope you all must be fine, right? So today we are going to read for class 4 Science Olympiad, okay? And in class 4 Science Olympiad, what we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss the previous year questions of NSO Level 2 exam, okay? So are you all ready for it? Yes, so let's get started. Our first question, study the two life cycles X and Y and select the option that correctly identifies the organism which saw these cycles respectively. X, that is the options are A, mosquito, butterfly, B, lizard, frog, C, mosquito, frog, D, grasshopper, dragonfly. Okay. Yes. So here, what is the given here? Egg is converted to larva, then larva is converted to pupa, pupa to adult. Okay, so this is the X. So this is the life cycle of a mosquito, right? Next one is adult to egg to tadpole, tadpole to adult. So this is the life cycle of frog. So what will be the correct answer? That will be X is the mosquito and Y is the frog. And where it is present? It is present in option C. That's why option C is the correct answer. Got it? Coming to the next question. Study the given figure carefully. It will be toughest to lift the rock when the force is applied at X, while it will be easiest to do the same when the force is applied at Y. Now select the correct option regarding X and Y. So option A, B, C. Option B, D, A. Option C, C, B. Option D and D. So it is given that a figure is given. So we have to find out it will be toughest to lift the frog when the force is applied at X and easiest to do the same when the force is applied at Y. Okay. So we have to find out in which place if we are applying the force, it will be toughest to lift the rock. So that will be the thing where it is closer to this point. Okay. So if it is closer to this point, so if we are applying force here, then also it will be difficult for the difficult to lift this rock. But if we are applying the force somewhat here, that is the distance from this, okay, this fulcrum, then it will be easier to lift the load. So here D, it is the place where we have, it is easiest, okay, that is Y, and A, it is the place where it will be difficult to lift the rock. So it will be X. So what will be the answer? That is X is A and Y is D. So correct answer is option D. Got it everyone? Coming to the next question, Rohini observed new moon on 27th October. Which phases of moon will she observe on 4th November and 11th November respectively? Option A, B, C, D. These are different pictures are given. Okay. So what we need to do? Rohini observed new moon on 27th October and the phases of moon she will observe on 4th November and 11th November respectively. So 27th October to 4th November. Okay. So that will be around that will be around 7 days. Okay. So it will be 7 days for the around 7 days for 4th November, and for the 11th November it will be around 15 days. Got it? So what will be the phase of the moon? Initially it is new moon. So from new moon to full moon, okay, it takes 15 days. We know that from new moon to full moon it takes 15 days. So in 7 days what will be there? So in 7 days new moon it will be completely dark, full moon it will be completely white. So that phase after 7 days it will be like this, right? And after 15 days, that is 11 November, it will be completely the full moon. So correct answer here is option D. Got it everyone? Coming to the next question, which of the following statements is incorrect? Option A, equator is an imaginary line that runs from North Pole to South Pole. B, the planet revolve around the sun in different orbits. C, the distance of the planet from the sun determines its revolution period. D, second planet from the sun has the highest temperature in our solar system. So we have to find out the incorrect statement here. So equator is an imaginary line that runs from North Pole to South Pole. This one is incorrect. We know equator, it is going towards, that is horizontally to the middle of the our Earth. Okay, then the planet revolve around the sun in different orbits. This one is correct. Distance of the planet from the sun determines the revolution period. Yes, this is also correct. The second planet from the sun has the highest temperature in our solar system. Yes, this one is also correct. So, which is the correct answer? That is the option A. Got it? Coming to the next question, the following graphs show the level of water pollution in a particular area. Which graph depicts that chemical factories have increased in this area over time? So here four options are given between time and water pollution level. At the time, it is given in the x-axis, and water pollution level, it is given in the y-axis. So we have to find out the level of water pollution in a particular area. Okay. And which graph depicts the chemical factories have increased in this area over time? So, if chemical factories are increased in an area, that means the water pollution level, it will increase with time. Okay. So, with time, we know if we move from left to right in x-axis, the value increases. Okay. And in the y-axis, if we move from bottom to top, okay, then the value increases. So here with the time, when we move from left to right, that is where the time is increasing, the pollution level is also increasing. We can say here is the point, here is the point. Okay, so the pollution levels are gradually increasing. That's why here the correct answer is option D. Got it? Coming to the next question, permanent teeth are of four types: incisors, canines, premolars and molars. What is the total number of each of these teeth in the mouth respectively? Option A 4, 2, 4, 6, B 8, 8, 4, 12, C 8, 4, 8, 12, D 4, 1, 4, 3. So in the question it is given permanent teeth are of four types: incisor, canines, premolars and molars. We know that, right? So, we have to find out the total number of each of these teeth in the mouth respectively. Okay. So, here we know if we are considering the upper part, okay, and to the one side of the jaw. So, if it is the upper part and one side of the jaw, so the numbers are like 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay, what are the numbers? These are 2, 1, 2, 3 for one side. So, if it is like 2, 1, 2, 3 for this side, so same is for this side and this side and this side, right? And what are the 2, 1, 2, 3? This is for incisor, canines, premolars and molars. So, what will be the total number? We can multiply 4. Right. So, for incisor, it will be 2 into 4, 8. For canines, it will be 4. 1 into 4, 4. For premolars, 2 into 4, again 8. And for molar, 3 into 4, 12. 8, 4, 8, 12. And where it is present? It is present in option C. Got it? Coming to the next question. Refer to the given graph showing the temperature changes at a place over a year. Select the incorrect option regarding it. Option A, at time Y, one should wear woolen sweater and gloves. Option B, at time Z, one should wear woolen coat and socks. Option C, at time X, one should wear cotton t-shirt and shorts. Option D, all of this. Okay. So, here, temperature changes at a place over a year, it's shown. We have to find the incorrect one, right? So x, y, z. So for x, if we will find out, the temperature will be somewhat around 40. And for y, if we extrapolate it, it will be somewhat around 35, okay. And for z, okay, so for z, it will be something around 10 degree, it will be something like around 35 degree, and here it will be around 40 degree. Now we have to find out what, you know, temperature that is more in case of summer, okay. So we can say here that x h for summer season, right, and y it is around at 45 degrees, so it is also the temperature for summer season. J that is around 10 degrees, so it will be the temperature for winter season. Now you have to decide, you have to think that what clothes we wear during what season, okay. In the first option, at time y, one should wear woolen sweater and gloves. At time y is summer. Do we wear woolen sweater and gloves during summer? No, right? So this one is incorrect. At time J, one should wear woolen coats and socks. J, that is winter. Yes, in winter we do wear woolen clothes and woolen coat and socks. Okay. Next one is C. At time X, one should wear cotton t-shirt and shorts. Yes, in summer season we prefer to wear cotton t-shirt and shorts. So this one is also correct. So which one is incorrect? That is option A. Got it? Coming to the next question. Refer to the given Venn diagram. Which letter in it best represents nitrogen gas? Okay. Option A, P, B, Q, C, R, D, S. So here it is given definite volume, definite shape and can be compressed. Okay. So nitrogen gas, it is a gas. And we know that gas, they do not have definite shape. Okay, gas do not possess definite shape. And about the definite volume also, they do not possess definite volume, right? But gas, they can be compressed. Gases, they can be compressed. Why they can be compressed? Because their particles are far apart from each other. So when we apply pressure, we can bring them closer. Okay. So that nitrogen gas should not contain this part, should not contain this part. It should only be present in this circle. Right. So according to this, S is the option where it can be a gas only. That's why the correct answer is option D, that is S. Okay. Coming to the next question. In the given food web, P, Q, R, S, T and U are consumers. Which of these consumers are only plant eaters? Option A, P and S, B, Q and T, C, R and Q, D, U and P. So, in the given food web, P, Q, R, S, T, U are consumers. Okay. We have to find out which of these consumers are only plant eaters. So only plant eaters. See here, if we start, R is only plant eater. U, it is not only plant eater. Okay. From this side also here and this side, another chain is there. So it is not only plant eater. Q, yes, Q is only plant eater. P, it is not only plant eater because here is another chain. Okay. T is also not the answer. S is also not the answer. So correct answer is R and Q. And where it is present? It is present in option C. Got it? Coming to the next question. Name of some fabrics can be obtained by using the letters given in the following box. So how many of these fabrics are obtained from plants? Okay. So here we can see that cotton is there, right? How many of these fabrics are obtained from plants? Option A, 2, B, 3, C, 1, D, none of these. So here we can see that what are the fabrics that are obtained from plants? Do you know the answer? Yes. So these are the cotton, hemp, jute, flax, right? And we can say from the coconut coirs, we found that also. But here, whatever letters are there, if we just try to write the name of the fabric, yes, that will be cotton only, right? C-O-T-T-O-N. So it will be cotton. So this is the fabric which we are obtaining from plants. Coming to the next question, a scientist observed a sudden increase in the number of algae in a lake over a few days. So the reason behind it could be that option A, water cycle in the area got unbalanced. B, electronic wastes are being dumped in a nearby area. C, a factory with heavy smoke discharge has been established nearby. D, heavy amount of chemical fertilizers were being used in a nearby field. So in the question, it is given that a scientist observed a sudden increase in the number of algae in a lake over a few days. Okay, so we have to find what may be the reason. So what is the condition in which the number of algae in a lake that increases? It increases only in case of, let me write here, it increases only in case of water pollution. Okay, and among these options, what are the things? Water cycle in that area got unbalanced. No, it has nothing to do with water cycle. Electronic wastes were being dumped into the nearby area. No. A factory with heavy smoke discharges has been established nearby. No. Heavy amount of chemical fertilizers were being used in a nearby field. Yes, this can be the answer, because due to the heavy use of the chemical fertilizer in any nearby field, then the water of the lake, it will be polluted. Okay, coming to the next question, starting from the first letter, strike out every alternate letter to get the name of a food cooking method and select the correct option. So what we have to do, we have to, starting from the first letter, we have to strike out every alternate letter to get the name of a food cooking method. Okay, so yes, we have to strike this every alternate letters, we have to strike. So what we get? Yes, it is pickling. Okay, yes, coming to the next one, yes, we have to, yes, strike out the alternative letters. So it became canning. Okay, coming to the option C, let us strike the alternative letters. Yes, so it will be steaming. Right, next one. Okay, yes, what will be the answer? It is drying. Got it? So we have to find out the name of the food cooking method. This pickling, canning, drying. So these are the method of our preservation of food. These are not the method for cooking. Okay, but steaming is a method of cooking. That's why correct answer is option C. Coming to the next question, select the option that on unscrambling gives the name of a planet that rotates from east to west. So what we need to do, we just need to unscramble the name, whatever options are given here, okay, so that we will get the name of a planet that rotates from east to west. So do you know what is the answer, which planet that rotates from east to west? Yes, it is Uranus, right? And if we scramble these letters, then we will get the correct answer. So here the correct answer is option D. Got it? Coming to the next question, the dress shown in the picture is known as dress, and it is traditional dress, dress of dress. So option A, kimono, Australia. B, hanbok, Japan. C, Kalimundu, India. D, none of these. So here the correct answer is option D, none of these. Coming to the next question, study the given word grid carefully. How many natural fibers are hidden in the grid? Option A 3, B 4, C 5, D 2. Okay, so we have to find out how many natural fibers are hidden in the grid. So, here we get one cotton, right? Then after cotton, here we can get hemp, and after hemp, another one is flax, right? And here also we can start, it is jute, okay? And anything more? Yes, here another one is there, that is wool. So cotton, hemp, flax, wool, jute, total 5 numbers are there. So here correct answer is option C, that is 5. Coming to the next question, which of the following groups contain only egg-laying animals? Option A, parrot, crow, bear. Option B, crocodile, frog, wolf. Option C, frog, honeybee, platypus. D, hen, cockroach, seal. So we have to find out the group which contains only egg-laying animals. Okay. So here the correct answer is option C, that is frog, honeybee and platypus. These are the egg-laying animals. Okay. Coming to the next question. Group P contains microbes that are both harmful and useful to the mankind. They are used to make cheese and curd. They also cause diseases like tuberculosis and pneumonia. Identify the microbe that belong to the group P. Option A, bacteria. B, virus. C, fungus. D, protozoa. So group P contains microbes that are both harmful and useful for us, okay, and they are also used to make cheese and curd. Which are used to make cheese and curd? Yes, do you know the answer? Then they also cause the diseases like tuberculosis and pneumonia. You know tuberculosis and pneumonia, these are bacterial diseases, okay. So also this bacteria is helpful to make cheese and curd. So here the correct answer is option A, that is bacteria. Got it? Coming to the next question, which of the following statement is or are incorrect? Option A, firan is the traditional dress of Kashmir. 2, rose leaves are kept in folds of woolen cloths to protect them from damage by silverfish. 3, light colored cloths absorb more heat than dark colored cloths. Option A, 2 only. B, 2 and 3 only. C, 1 and 2 only. D, 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So here which one is incorrect we have to find out. So first one, firan is traditional dress of Kashmir, this one is correct. Rose leaves are kept in folds of woolen cloths to protect them from damage by silverfish. No. Light colored cloths absorb more heat than dark colored cloths. No, not at all. Dark colored cloths absorb more heat than light colored cloths. Okay, so 2 and 3 are incorrect, right? So here the correct answer is option B, 2 and 3 only. Got it? Coming to the next question, the plant X and Y are similar to each other as they both, option A, grow in soil that lack both air and water. B, have tentacles on leaves to trap insects. C, cannot photosynthesize. D, need to overcome the deficiency of nitrogen. So these two plants, okay, so these two plants, these are insectivorous plants, okay. So insectivorous plants means they trap insects, they release a liquid, they trap insect, and when the insect fall in the liquid, they stick to the liquid, okay, and they cannot go out. So eventually the insect will die. But why these insectivorous plants are doing this? Yes, they are doing this to overcome their deficiency of nitrogen. They are not getting nitrogen from the soil directly. So from that insect, they are trying to get the nitrogen. right? So here the correct answer is option D, need to overcome deficiency of nitrogen. Coming to the next one, study the given relationship and select the option which shows the similar relationship. Coffee seeds, option A carrot flower, B cabbage leaves, C broccoli root, D radish stem. So a given relationship is there and we have to find the similar relationship. So coffee that is from seeds, okay, similarly cabbage that consists of leaves. So here the correct answer is option B, cabbage leaves. Got it everyone? Yes. So in our today's session we have discussed some questions of previous year level 2 exam, okay. In our next session we are going to discuss some more questions of this level 2 questions, okay. So till then, read mindfully, okay. So meet you soon. Bye bye everyone.